Most noble brother, you have done me wrong.
Judge me, you gods. Wrong I mine enemies? And if not so, how should I wrong a brother?
Brutus, this sober form of yours hides wrongs, and when you do that,
Cassius, be content. I do know you well. For the eyes of both our armies here, which should proceed nothing but love from us, let us not wrangle. Bid them move away. Then in my tent, Cassius, and lodge your griefs, and I will give you audience.
Pindarus! Bid our commanders lead their charges off a little from this ground.
Lucilius, do you the like, and let no man come to our tent till we have done our conference. And Lucius and Titanius guard our door.
That you have wronged me doth appear in this. You have condemned the note to Lucius Pella for taking bribes here of the Sardians, were in my letters praying on his side because I knew the man.
You wronged yourself to write in such a case.
In such a time as this, it is not meet that every nice offense should bear his comment.
Let me tell you, Cassius, you yourself are much condemned to have an itching palm to sell him out your offices for gold to undeserve.
Aye, an itching palm. You know that you are Brutus that speaks this, or by the gods, this speech were else your last.
The name of Cassius honors his corruption, and chastisement doth therefore hide his head.
Chastisement?
Remember March. The Ides of March, remember. Do not great Julius plead for justice' sake? What villain touched his body that did stab enough at justice? But shall one of us that struck the foremost man of all this world before supporting robbers, shall we now contaminate our fingers with base bribes? And sell the mighty space of our large honors for so much trash as may be grasped thus? By the gods, I had rather be a dog and bathe the moon than such a Roman.
Brutus, bathe not me, I'll not endure it. You forget yourself to hedge me. I am a soldier. I, older in practice, abler than yourself to make conditions.
You're too, Cassius, you are not.
I am!
I say you are not!
Urge me no more, I shall forget myself. Have mind upon your health. Tempt me no further.
Away! Slight man.
Is it come to this?
Hear me, for I will speak. Must I give way in room to your rash choler? Shall I be frightened when a madman stares?
Oh, ye gods, shall I endure all this?
All this? I, more, fret to your proud heartbreak.
Go show your slaves how choleric you are, and make your bondmen tremble. Must I budge? Must I observe you? Must I stand and crouch under your testy humor? By the gods, you shall digest the venom of your spleen that would split you.
For from this day forth, I'll use you for my mirth, yeah, for my laughter when you are waspish.
Is it come to this?
You say you are a better soldier. Let it appear so. Make your vaunting true, and it shall please me well. For mine own part, I shall be glad to learn of noblemen.
You wrong me every way. You wrong me, Brutus. I said an elder soldier, not a better. Did I say better?
You did, I care not.
When Caesar lived, he durst not thus have moved me.
Peace, peace! You durst not thus have tempted him.
I durst not!
No!
What? Durst not tempt him.
For your life, you durst not tempt him.
There is no terror, Cassius, in your threats. For I am armed so strong in honesty that they pass me by as the idle wind, which I respect not. I did send to you for certain sums of gold, which you denied me. For I can raise no money by vile means. By the heavens, I had rather coin my heart and drop my blood for drachmas than drink from the hard hands of peasants their vile trash by any indirection. I did send to you for gold to pay my legions, which you denied me. Was that done like Cassius? Should I have answered Caius Cassius, sir?
When Marcus Brutus grows so covetous to lock such rascal counters from his friends.
Be ready, gods! With all your thunderbolts, dash him to pieces!
I denied you not!
You did!
I did not! He was but a fool that brought my answer back. Brutus hath raved my heart.
A friend should bear his friend's infirmities, but Brutus makes mine greater than
they are. I do not till you practice them on me.
You love me not.
I like not your faults.
Friendly eye could never see such faults.
A flatterer's would not. Though they do appear as huge as high Olympus.
Oh, come, Antony and young Octavius, come. Avenge yourselves alone on Cassius, for Cassius is a weary of the world, hated by the one he loves, checked like a bondman, all his faults observed, learned and conned by rote to cast into my deed. I could weep the spirit from my eyes. He is my diamond, and here my naked breast, within a heart dearer than bosom, richer than gold. Thou beest the Roman taking toward me. I, that deny thee gold, will give my heart. Strike, as thou didst that Caesar, for I know when thou hatest him more, thou lovest him better than ever thou lovest Cassius.
Sheathe your dagger. Be angry when you will, it shall have scope. Oh, Cassius. You are yoked to the lamb that carries anger as the flint bears fire, who much at force shows a hasty spark and straight is cold again.
Hath Cassius lived to be but mirth and laughter to his Brutus when grief and blood ill-tempered vexed him?
When I spoke that, I was ill-tempered too.
You confess so much. Give me your hand.
My heart too.
Brutus, what's the matter now? Have you not love enough to bear with me when that rash humor which my mother gave me makes me forgetful?
Yes. Cassius. Then from henceforth, when you are over earnest with your Brutus, you'll think your mother chides. I'll leave you so.